Inter-University Accelerator Centre is a novel concept for equitable distribution and optimal utilization of resources in the country, especially in the area of accelerator-related physics. Not all the universities can have same facility everywhere. This idea of having Inter-University Accelerator Centre here in Delhi, it caters to the needs of all the researchers in the country. So it is a kind of capacity building in several such areas. Research carried out at Inter-University Accelerator Centre are primarily in the areas of nuclear science, material science, atomic and molecular physics, radiation biology, geochronology, and other allied areas where the accelerators are needed. For example, we do carry out experiments for single event upset for all the payloads through satellite in the space. Accelerator knowledge is important in India because the experiments which we do in nuclear physics, in other areas, they do require accelerators. Students are trained in several such technologies, for example, vacuum technology, high voltages, and command control systems, because they have to operate the machines remotely. We are also adding more accelerators to get range from kilo electron volt to mega electron volt.
At present, we have three different DC accelerators. 1.7 million volt electron is used for Rutherford backscattering, while 500 kilovolt electron is used for carbon 14 dating studies. The Accelerator Mass Spectrometry program was started with 15 UD electron, and this program was established to study beryllium 10 isotopes. And after that, this 500 kilovolt accelerator was established dedicated for carbon 14.
The pelotron accelerator at Inter-University Accelerator Center can accelerate heavy ions up to mass 40 above the Coulomb barrier in symmetric reactions. In order to increase this mass range up to mass 100 atomic mass unit, the superconducting linear accelerator booster was planned. The superconducting linear accelerator uses superconducting niobium quarter wave resonators, which are made out of bulk niobium material, which becomes superconducting at 9.2 Kelvin. The resonators themselves are actually cooled down to 4.2 Kelvin using liquid helium. This was the first such facility which was set up in India, and we have used this facility to build the required resonators for the superconducting LINAC. We have also helped other institutions within India in realizing elliptical cavities for different velocities and different designs.
In Inter-University Accelerator Center, we have many areas of research in which we do experiments. Some of them are like nanostructuring with ion beams, nanocomposites, band gap engineering in semiconductors. We have also very interesting programs in electromagnetic shielding and microwave absorption. We have many front-ranking offline characterization facilities like transmission electron microscope, scanning electron microscope, atomic force microscope. We have Raman and XRD. We have transport measurements facilities. We have also a solar simulation. And one unique thing we have is this Raman and XRD we have in situ in the beamline, which is one of the few facilities in the world. In future, we see more synergy between the basic research we generally do in the universities and applied research, which has a requirement from the industries and other applications of national importance.
At Inter-University Accelerator Center, we carry out nuclear studies in nuclear dynamics and structure using two large recoil mass spectrometers, two large gamma detector arrays, and a large neutron detector array, and a general purpose scattering chamber. The kind of things we are looking at is, we excite a nucleus or form a nucleus which doesn't exist in nature through heavy ion reaction. The nuclear phenomena which we study are elastic and inelastic scattering, transfer, breakup, fusion and fission reactions. The first recoil mass separator, heavy ion reaction laser or HERA, was designed in 87 and set up in 91. It was the first in Asia of its kind. And we put it to use to produce the first radioactive ion beam of the country. It has a power of reducing the background from a trillion to nothing. Same is the case with hybrid recoil mass analyzer. And the gamma detector array can look at the gamma and their energies exactly from nuclei and identify the nucleus like we use our fingerprints to detect human beings.
The future vision would be to cater to the needs of the country researchers in terms of energy of ion species, and also we are going to add free electron lasers for terahertz radiation. We would like to identify the satellite centers which have started coming up in universities to augment, to supplement, and sometimes to complement the facilities which we have here in IUAC New Delhi.